गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे एक्सरसाइज 7.3 यूनिटरी मेथड। व्हाट इज यूनिटरी मेथड? यू ऑल नो दैट द वैल्यू ऑफ अ यूनिट क्वांटिटी इज ऑब्टेन्ड फर्स्ट टू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ द रिक्वायर्ड क्वांटिटी। एंड द बेसिक प्रिंसिपल ऑफ यूनिटरी मेथड इज टू डिवाइड टू गेट लेस एंड मल्टीप्लाई टू गेट मोर। सपोज प्राइस ऑफ 5 बुक्स इज गिवन। 5 books cost is rupees 335 and you have to find cost of 7 books. So what we do in this? First we find the cost of one book. Cost of one book will be 335 divided by 5. So we will get here rupees 67 after cancelling it. 67 is the cost of one book. So what will be the cost of 7 books? Cost of 7 books will be 7 multiplied by 67, that is equal to 469. This is the general method we apply whenever we have to solve any word problem using unitary method. To find out the one quantity, we need to divide, and you have to find many quantity, then we will multiply. So unitary method is divided into two parts, that is first is direct variation and the another is inverse variation. In direct variation, two quantities are said to be indirect if increase or decrease in one quantity cause a corresponding increase or decrease in the other quantity. Suppose 5 pencils cost rupees 20. Cost of 5 pencil is rupees 20. Then what will be the cost of 10 pencil? Tell me, 5 pencil cost rupees 20, then 10 pencil cost rupees what? 40. So here what we are doing, more is the amount of money, more is the number of pencils. So number of pencils and amount of money are in direct variation. Means if this quantity and this quantity both is increasing, if cost is increasing, the number of pencil will increase. Number of pencil will increase, then cost will also increase. Such kind of variation is called direct variation. And we use division to find the value of unit quantity, means one quantity. In direct variation, always divide to find out the unit quantity. Suppose 5 pencil cost rupees 20 and you have to find the cost of 10 pencil. So first of all, we will find out the cost of 1 pencil. What will be the cost of 1 pencil? 20 divided by 5. So 2 4s are 20. So 4 is the cost of 1 pencil. So what will be the cost of 10 pencil? 10 into 4, that is equal to 40. So in direct variation, to find out the unit quantity, we divide. But in inverse variation, what happens? To find out the unit quantity, we multiply. Okay? So two quantities are said to be in inverse variation if an increase or decrease in one quantity causes a corresponding decrease or increase in another quantity. Suppose 5 men can complete a work in 8 days. 5 men are taking 8 days to complete a work. Suppose one man can complete the same work in how many days? If number of men is less, then definitely he will take more time to complete the work. So he will complete the work in 40 days. 5 men can complete in 8 days, but one man can complete in 40 days. Means if the number of men is lesser, to complete the work, more is the number of days required. And if the number of men is more, then days will be less taken, time will be taken less to complete the work. Means this is in, if it will increase, then this will decrease. And this side will decrease, then this side will increase. If this kind of variation is there, then this is called inverse variation. And we use multiplication to find the value of a unit quantity in inverse variation. You can see 5 men, this is in inverse variation. So 5 men can complete a work in 8 days. So 1 man can complete a work in 5 into 8 days. We will multiply here to find one man walk. But here what we were doing? We were dividing to find one quantity, unit quantity value. But in inverse variation, we will multiply to find out the unit quantity value. Suppose one man can complete a work in 40 days, then 8 men can complete a work in how many days? So, 1 man can complete in 40 days, then 8 men can complete in, divided by, just divide this by 8, 5 days. 8 men can complete a work in 5 days. Understood what is direct variation and inverse variation? Now, let's start exercise 7.3, question number 1. A car uses 30 liter of petrol to cover a distance of 375 kilometer. How many liter will be needed to cover a distance of 1200 kilometer? Means petrol, first of all find out it is in direct variation or in inverse variation. If petrol will increase, then the distance can also be covered more. Means if petrol is more, distance will also be more. And if petrol is less, then the distance will also be covered less. So, this is in direct variation because both the quantity is increasing or decreasing together. So, here a car uses 30 liter petrol to cover distance this much. Then how many liter of petrol will be required? So, you have to find the liter of petrol. So, you will solve it like this. Petrol needed to cover 375 kilometer is equal to 30 liter. Then petrol needed to cover 1 kilometer is equal to what? You are finding 1 unit quantity. So here it is in direct variation, so we will divide 30 divided by 375, and you can cancel it out. 6 times and 75, 6 by 75 liter of petrol will be required to cover 1 kilometer, but we have to find petrol needed to cover 1200 kilometer. So 6 by 75 multiplied by 1200, so we will cancel out, we will get 96 liter petrol needed to cover the distance of 1200 kilometer. So this was in direct variation. Simple unitary method we have applied here. Now next question. Question number 2. An alloy is formed by mixing 4.5 gram copper and 2.8 gram zinc. How much alloy of similar kind can be formed by using 13.5 gram copper? So here what is happening? Means alloy will be formed by mixing these two, zinc and copper, then quantity of certain quantity of alloy will be formed. Then how much alloy will be similar kind can be formed by using 13.5 gram copper? If here 4.5 gram copper is mixed with zinc, then one alloy is formed. Then how much alloy will be formed by using this much copper? Then we need to find the how much zinc will be required to mix in this. Then we will add this two quantity and find out the alloy. So, look at here. First of all, this question is in direct or inverse variation. Find it out. So, this question is in direct variation. Because more copper and zinc will be mixed, then more alloy will be formed. And if less copper and zinc will be mixed, then less alloy will be formed. Simple, it is direct. So, zinc required for making an alloy of mixing 4.5 gram of copper is equal to 2.8 gram. That is given in question. So, zinc required for making an alloy by mixing 1 gram copper will be equal to, we will divide to find out the unit quantity. So, 2.8 divided by 4.5. If you will remove the decimal, 110 will come. 0 will get cancelled, 28 by 45. Now, zinc required for making an alloy by mixing 13.5 gram copper. Zinc, first of all, we are finding out the zinc. How much zinc will be required, okay? So, 13.5 gram copper. So, 28 by 45 into this multiplied by 13.5, okay? So, if you will get cancelled, it will get cancelled, then the answer will be 8.4 gram. Zinc will be required. Now, 8.4 gram zinc and 13.5 gram copper will make an alloy of similar kind. Alloy of similar kind will be this plus this, that is 21.9 gram, okay? So, this was in direct variation. Now, question number 3. In a summer camp, there was provision for soaps for 45 students for 30 days. Means 45 students are there and soap is lasts for them for 30 days. For how many students will be will the same soap last for 27 days? Means, if find out first it is in direct variation or inverse variation. If the number of students will be more, soap will last for less days, soap will get finished soon. If the number of students will be more, then soap will last for less days. But if the number of students will be less, soap will last for more days. So here you can see number of days is less, means definitely more students. How many students? Means more student will use, that's why soap lasts for 27 days only. So this is in inverse variation, because students more, then soap lasts for less days. So this is in inverse. So just see this, how to solve this. Number of students for whom provision for soap is 30 days is equal to 45 students given. So number of students for whom provision lasts for 1 day, first of all we will find out. So 1 day means it is in inverse variation. So 1 day unit quantity if you are finding out, so we will multiply. And in direct variation for unit quantity we divide. Okay, so it is in inverse variation. So 45 multiplied by 35. So we will get 1350 students will use. Now number of students for whom soap lasts for 27 days is equal to this divided by 27. So we will cancel it out. 50 student will be the answer. Next is question number 4. A hostel has enough food to feed 115 children for 88 days. After a week, 20 more children join the hostel. For how many days will the remaining food last? Remaining means how much the food will left after a week, because after 1 week 20 more student join. So remaining food will last for how many days you have to find. And you can see this is also in inverse variation, because if the number of children will be more, food will last for less days. And if the number of children will be less, food will last for more days. So this is in inverse variation. So to solve this, look at here. After 7 days, there is food left for, after a week, how much food left for how many days? 88 minus 7 days. So 81 days. Now new student joined. So total number of student after joining the new student will be 115 plus 20 is equal to 135 student. For 115 children, food lasts for 81 days. It is given in the question. So for, yes, it is given in the question that for 115 student, food will last for 88 days. But after a week, 7 days passed, now 81 days left, so 115 children, food last for 81 days. Now for one child, food will last for, here we are going to find the unit quantity. So it is in inverse variation, so we will multiply to find out the unit quantity. So this multiplied by this, so 9315, we will get the one child food last. For 135 student, food will last for 93, this divided by 135, that is 69 days. So food will last for 69 days for 135 students. Got it? Question number 5. A bike can cover a certain distance with a speed of 56 km per hour in 6 hours. Means a certain distance covered by the bike at this speed in 6 hours. So what should be the speed of the bike if the same distance is to be covered in 8 hours? We have to find the speed of the bike. So it is very simple. So a bike can cover certain distance in 6 hours at a speed of 56 km per hour. So bike can cover in 1 hour in at what speed it will cover that same distance. Here you will write same distance. In 1 hour, 56 multiplied by 6, 1 we will multiply here because it is in inverse variation. Because if speed will be more, distance will be covered at less time. And if the speed will be less, distance will be covered at more time. So we will multiply it to find out the unit quantity. 336 km per hour. Now bike will cover same distance in 8 hours at a speed of 336 divided by 8. That is 42 km per hour will be the answer. Okay students, up to 1 to 5 I have explained you. Question number 6, 7, 8, 9 you have to try by yourself. Any doubt you can ask me in the group. Okay.